Ciao, ciao, Fetu. And welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, this channel is all about self-healing, self-improvement, counseling, YouTube tutorials, and how to brew your own liquor at the comfort of your own home. Today's topic, we're going to be talking about 7 things to do to ease anxiety. 7 things to do to ease anxiety. 1. We must always acknowledge and question the anxiety. Né? Why is it there? What is it trying to bring your awareness to? Are things changing around you? What are you mostly anxious about? 2. Focus on now. Sounds crazy, but yeah. Because most of the time our anxiety is caused by us always projecting to the future or always overthinking things or looking back on our past experience or just in general dwelling on the worst possible outcomes that we might think of. So focus on the present moment in order for us to reach our fullest potential. 3. Always visualize the best possible outcomes. What if it works out? How will that make you feel? Good, right? I'm sure it would make me feel good as well. Look at things through your third eye and always see the bigger picture in everything you're trying to do in life. That's how you're gonna pass through your anxieties. 4. Don't judge yourself. Yeah, I know, don't judge yourself. Don't judge yourself by or because you have anxiety attacks here and there. No. But rather, always recite mantras out loud. I have a video about a mantra somewhere here. I will link it and leave the link in the description below. I think it will help you understand what are mantras and how to use mantras even when you're in an anxious state or your subconscious ain't working in your favor. Always recite mantras. 5. Give yourself permission to let go. Sometimes you hold on things even though they ain't working out, and even though those things hit us the most. I think we are a generation of people who fears a lot of letting go rather than looking out for yourself. So always give yourself permission to let go. If something is not for you, it's not for you. 6. Always ask yourself, what do I need to do to give myself permission to ease this anxiety? The more you talk to yourself about trying to ease your anxiety, that's the more you're gonna get answers on how to ease your anxiety, and that's how you're gonna actually learn or always reflect on how to ease your anxiety and make you feel good every time you're having an anxiety attack. 7. Repeat step 3. So step 3 basically is visualizing the best possible outcomes. Always see the bigger picture. I always tell people that there's always a silver lining in everything that's happening in life, you know. And there's always a reason why things happen in life. So now if you can try to look at the bigger picture and always try, or maybe you can try to see the silver lining in you having an anxiety attack, then that means somewhere your inner self or your inner energies or your chakras are not balanced that well. That's how sometimes most of us don't feel good about ourselves. Always visualize the best possible outcomes at all times. That's how you're gonna feel good about yourself. Nagali ina kitatsidai. Spiderman Samotswana. Kiri. Namaste. See you on the next video. Please like, subscribe, share, comment. Help me help you to grow this channel. I think I will always shoot here. This window light and the shadows. It's too nice. I think I should use this spot as my shooting spot, in fact, from now on. And be like, Shosho, I've heard you knock on the neck, that's it, and welcome back to the YouTube channel. But, yeah. Bye.